This segment is on how to make great mashed potatoes. I have seen fabulous mashed potatoes. I've seen wimpy mashed potatoes. I've seen pathetic mashed potatoes. And I've seen people stressed over mashed potatoes. I've watched it Thanksgiving where someone at the last minute says, "Oh, the gravy, the mashed potatoes." And I'm thinking, you know what? Mashed potatoes are simple. You can actually have them done ahead of time. And so let's go through the basics of it. You start with russet potatoes, the great mealy potatoes that give you a great dry potato when you mash it. So we're going to peel it. Now, there's some people that like their potatoes with the skin on, and I'm not a huge fan of that, but if that's what you like, then scrub the potatoes well. Now, the one prep step that you can do ahead of time is you can prep the potatoes, you can peel them, you can cut them into cubes, and you can or cut them into big chunks and put them in a pot of cold water and leave them. And they can be left for several hours. You don't need to do this at the last minute. What you want are even chunks so that they all cook at the same rate. And the recipe that I have on the website that's in my Thanksgiving book, in my Christmas book, is for where you take 2.5 pounds of russet potatoes, you do the same prep for all of them, you bring the water, salted water, to a boil, you cook the potatoes until a fork, a meat fork or just a table fork, can go in and they're tender. So I happen to have cooked a pot ahead. So let me swap these out and I'll show you. Okay, so this is salted water. The potatoes have simmered and they're fork tender, and that's what you want. So what I'm going to do is take these over to the sink and I'm going to drain the potatoes and in a colander put them back into the pan. And what you want to do is allow the, here, I'll scoot this out of the way, and it allows any water that's left on the bottom of the pan, any of the potatoes that have water, I want to get that water off so that they're dried out. So you just do them for a second over the heat, and then I turn the heat off. Let me show you that the potatoes are dry, there's no water left in the bottom of the pan, and we're ready to mash. There's multiple tools you can use to mash potatoes, and there's one tool you never want to use to mash a potato. So the simplest thing is to have a potato masher. And you get a little bit of texture. You can use what's called a ricer, which gives you a finer texture. You never ever, you can use a mixer if you want with what's called the paddle attachment. You never ever want to use a food processor. If you want glue, use a food processor. But otherwise, use a potato masher. So here is this trick that I learned years ago from a food scientist. This is usually when you mash potatoes, you have butter, melted butter, and warm milk. You want to start with warm milk because you don't want to cool off the potatoes. Now, and I experimented with this, it's so interesting. If you put, instead of mixing the milk and butter, which is often what's described in recipes, if you actually put the butter in first, it absorbs into the cells of the potatoes and you get a butterier potato. Okay? So we're gonna start, we're gonna use a little bit of muscle here and we're gonna use the potato masher to mash these potatoes. And I will do this for a second and I'll tilt the pan. But if you need to do this while the potatoes are hot. So once the potatoes are cooked, you gotta step into action until they're fully mashed and the liquids and the milk and the butter put in. Now there's lots of options for flavoring if you want to do that. This is basic. You could heat the milk with garlic and you could have garlic, roasted garlic potatoes. Or, you know, some people like to add some truffle oil into at the end. You can put some herbs into the milk and or even add herbs into the potatoes. Okay, so we've broken those up and got them mashed down. Now, I'm going to add in the butter. And I have, it's just under a cup of butter. And we're going to start with part of that and get that absorbed in. For the segment, I didn't measure exactly because I wanted to make sure I had enough depending on the potatoes in the pan. So I'm going to add in just a tad more butter. Set that aside. Okay, and then we're going to add in the milk, warmed milk. And I just did this, if you have a microwave, I just did this in the microwave. So it saves another pot to wash. But if you're going to add in, if you're going to try to infuse the milk, then you'll need to do that stovetop. So there's the potatoes. And we'll add in a small portion of the milk. Don't dump it all in, because you want to control the consistency. Now, the trick with the mashed potatoes, so I'm stirring this around, continuing to press down on the masher. And if you like a dry potato, then add less milk. I happen to like it pretty creamy. And since the cook rules, you know, the cook gets to decide. Although if you have a really good dishwasher, they get to kind of partially rule because you love when they clean up. So I've mixed in the milk. And then you're going to want to do a taste. I'll just use my fingers. Yum. I'm going to add a little bit more salt. Now the clever cook, and I happen to have one, the clever cook would use ground white pepper. Now this is advanced a little bit, but because the black pepper is going to leave dark specks. So you can even buy one of the little ready-made pepper mills that has white peppercorns in it, which would be a handy thing to have. Okay, we'll do one more taste. And those are good to go. What you want to do is transfer the potatoes to a heat-proof bowl, a microwave-safe bowl, or to the top of a double boiler, and then you can reheat the potatoes easily. So let's scoop these in. Look at that, fabulous consistency, little bit of texture to them because we used the masher. And we'll just pile those on up and they're ready to serve. And you know, you could sprinkle some herbs over the top, drizzle a little more butter, but that to me is mashed potato perfection.